Todd, CBS FM. That's the Crossfire, and that did move that song, didn't
it?
Yeah. Moved faster than the Orleans could, I guess. All right, here at CBS FM, Steve Caldwell is my guest, and I asked him while we were listening to Crossfire, is there a song that, you know, he sang lead on that we could give a listen to, and he picked one out called, Stranded in the Jungle.
Yeah,
that was a cover of The Cadets, and this is you doing what? You said you sang it in that frog voice.
I sang the whole song in the frog voice.
That became a trademark, as you said.
Yes, I call that my novelty, too.
Okay, can we give a listen?
Appreciate that.
Back in the States. Meanwhile, back in the jungle. When I found out they were cooking me.
Quick, Kookaboo, let me out of here.
Meanwhile, back in the States. Meanwhile, back in the jungle.
Liking that. That's good. That's a good version of that. That's, of course, Stranded in the Jungle with my guest, Steve Caldwell, on lead. And you recall why you guys picked that particular tune to record?
It was just doing covering some other people's tunes. I like to do the novelty stuff. And that was one that I just wanted to do. And they said, okay, you know.
All right. Sometimes the powers that be didn't say okay, though. And,
definitely. Plenty of times.
Did you ever want to record something that they wouldn't let you do?
Yes, plenty of times. Uh-huh. That was something I wrote a lot. And our things were never commercial enough for them, and I couldn't understand that point, you know. As you say, sometimes you let something go and see what happens. You know, if it doesn't happen, then you can say, I told you so.
Yeah.
But, you know, we were never given that opportunity. They nipped us in the bud.
Okay. <as they say. laughs> We're going to come back with Steve Caldwell and talk some more here in the Doo-Wop Shop.
Yeah.
at 101.1. That's Don't Hang Up. And at CBS FM, Orlans, of course, and Steve Caldwell's here. Now, you always did that up-tempo kind of song. I mean, that you seem to fall into that bag. Did they ever, or did you ever want to do a ballad-type song and have that as, or were you just happy having these hit records, whether they were up-tempo or whatever?
Getting the records to make the charts was a thing.
That was the main concern.
Main concern. And being young and not really knowing about the business, we had to take the lead of the people that, we entrusted them with our futures in that sense, you know, because they were the music people. We were the music providers mm-hmm. in that sense. You know, if they felt it was right, that's what we did. They did give us the opportunity to do some slow stuff on albums. Mm-hmm. You know, the first thing we did, I'll Be True, didn't make it for them in the slow vein.
Right.
The Mr. 21 didn't make it in the slow vein. And I have to say that this is kind of what they felt. Take them out of that and see what happens. And once we, you know, went into the up-tempo things, they continued to do well for us. You know, if the horse is running, we'll stand in front of them to stop him.
That's right. Having those hits, why quibble with success, right?
Exactly.
Now, what I want to ask you is, Steve Caldwell himself, before he ever heard of the Orlans or met these ladies, and prior to the times in high school, what started you singing, and how far back does it go, to when you were very young, or is that when it started in high school?
That goes to the mother being on the church choir and having to go to church all day Sunday night, mm-hmm. Thursdays and Tuesdays, whatever church meeting there was, and that meant being involved with the choir mm-hmm. in church, and